Hi everybody, I am Dr. Anju Babu. So before I start my lesson, let's look at the Ravi's story. Ravi is a teacher. He is not going to school since the lockdown. He is taking rest at home, but he teaches English and social. Let's look at the last line. He teaches English and social. So this teaching is his profession and he does it every day. So whatever we do regularly as part of job or as part of our habit, if you do something regularly, that should be in present simple. Okay? So that should be in simple present tense. Today, we are going to learn simple present tense. Guys, let's try to understand how does simple present tense is used in English. So there are three things we need to remember while we are using simple present tense. Firstly, simple present tense is used for habitual actions and repeated actions. Second one is, it is used to express actions which are universal truths and facts. It is used for proverbs and quotations. Let's look at the first one. So guys, first thing, is it describes habitual actions and repeated actions. So habitual actions are a part of our habits. We do it sometimes regularly, often. And repeated actions, few things we repeat it. So for habitual actions and repeated actions, we use simple present tense. Right? This is simple present tense. Guys, so look at the examples. Ravi teaches English. So what does it mean? Ravi is at home due to lockdown. He's not teaching right now. But what does he do regularly or as part of his job, as part of habit, he teaches. Okay, he goes to school. Then look at the next one. I usually get up early in the morning. So that means this is my habit. I get up early in the morning. They play cricket. Okay. So every day they go to a field and they play cricket. She always forgets her phone. Okay. So maybe it is irritating, but she does it. She always forgets a phone. And look at the other example. Rahul returns home at 7 p.m. Rahul, as after his job, every day he comes back home at 7 p.m. You guys look at the sentences. Okay, look here, Ravi teaches English, but when it comes to they play cricket, here we wrote play, here teaches. Okay, let's try to understand the form of a simple present tense. What kind of form that we use? Ravi teaches English. Okay guys, let's look at the form to easily understand. So in this form, you will have a subject V1, SRES plus object. So here SRES is optional. It doesn't come always. Look at the examples. For example, if you look at these subjects, I, we, you, they, it doesn't take S or ES. Okay, so I teach English, we teach English, you teach English, they teach English, he teaches English. Look at the difference. So here, only teach, here teaches. He teaches English, she teaches English, Raju teaches English. Right. Guys, try to understand the difference. So singular subjects do not, singular subjects takes S or ES, and the plural subjects are first person and second person subjects do not take S or ES. Guys, next one is universal truths or facts. We use simple present tense for describing universal truths and fats. So here, if you look at the examples, given five examples are describing the universal truths. The earth goes round the sun. Water freezes at 0 degrees. Plants give us oxygen. The sun rises in the east. The magnet attracts iron. So these are all universal facts. So if you look at the form, so here earth is singular. So go has taken ES. So that is goes. Next, water is a singular, freezes. Plants, plural, it's a give, not gives. The sun is singular, so sun rises. Magnet is singular, so attracts. Right, this is the second rule that you need to remember. Guys, so third point is proverbs and quotations. Simple present tense describes proverbs and quotations. Take a look at the examples. Time and tide wait for none. Slow and steady wins the race. Empty vessels make the greatest sound. These are all quotations. Nice. Now look at negative form. How to make negative sentences in simple present tense. Let's look at the example. He teaches English. So this is the positive sentence. This is the positive sentence. So look at the negative sentence. This is, he does not teach English. Positive is, he teaches English. Negative is, he doesn't teach English. So how to make negative sentence? To make negative sentences, you have to take do or does plus not to make negative sentence. So you can make it a not, do not or does not. So do not or does not depends on the subject. So since there is a singular subject here, he is a singular subject. Now he doesn't teach English. Now look at the second example. They go to school regularly. So negative sentence is, they don't go to school regularly. Okay? They do not or don't. They don't go to school regularly. This is the negative form here. Don't. So here does not, here don't. Why? The reason is, this is the subject. Subject is a plural. So they means maybe two people or three people or more than two. So that's why it takes do not, here does not. So I'll give you some sentences, you make them negative sentence. I go to office. So how do you make it a negative sentence? I don't go to office. She goes out. She doesn't go out. So here, when you make a does not, remember, here teach, it has a yes or yes, no? It has yes. So here, you should not add yes or yes, because there is a does. So you don't need to bring here. You have to leave it. He does not teach English. Okay. So next thing, use, no, questions. So questions are two types. Yes or no questions, WH questions. Yes or no questions, you look at yes or no questions. How to make yes or no questions? As we take do or does to make negative sentences. So here also, you have to take do or does to make yes or no questions. Right here, you look at the sentence. He plays tennis. How do you ask yes or no question? He plays tennis. You have to say, does he play tennis? Does he play tennis? Because this is a singular. He, third person singular. So does he play tennis? Next one, I stay in Hyderabad. So I is a first person. So you have to take a do. Start the question with do. For I, we, they, etc. You have to take do for making questions. Do I stay in Hyderabad? Do I stay in Hyderabad? Next, she writes a blog. she writes a blog. Does she write a blog? Does she write a blog? Babu makes short films. Babu makes short films. Does Babu make short films? Okay. So these are the questions, guys. To make negative, to make similar questions, you have to take do or does and make it a question. You guys see the finally double H questions. How do we make double H questions? Look at the questions given here. What do you do? Why do you wake up early? How does he go to his workplace? Where does he stay? How often do you visit your hometown? Look here, you're starting with what, and here do, it depends on do or does, it depends on the subject. Okay, and the question form, first you have to take what or why or how, etc., and then you have to add do or does, that depends on subject. For example, see, what is, if there is a subject he, it will become does. What does he do? What does he do? Because the subject is he. In the same way, why do you wake up early? Change the subject here. Why does he wake up early? Why does he wake up early? How does he go to his office, his workplace? Okay, for example, here the subject is they. How do they go? How do they go? So where does he stay? Where does he stay? Where do they stay? Single. For example, if it is a they, then where do they stay? How often do you visit your hometown? So these are all about questions, guys. Guys, did you understand simple present tense? So please write your response. How do you feel in the comment box? If you like my video, please like it, comment and share with your friends and subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to press the bell icon. Thank you.